Everybody, welcome to the videos on lineup building for week four of the NFL season over on DraftKings, talking cash game and GPP strategy. This is a very exciting slate, in my opinion. Lots of ways to go in cash, lots of ways to go in GPPs, lots of good stacks, so should definitely be a very fun one to talk about. And if you do find this video helpful in any way possible, make sure you leave a like, subscribe to the channel if you haven't yet already. If you want to take that one step further, an official member over on Patreon, link is down below in the description for that. And it's the beginning of the month, so it is the best time to do so. You get access to all the sheets, projections, ownership, all the data you'd ever need, color-coded nice and neat. So it's very easy to follow. Cheat Sheets, Discord Committee, and a bunch of other stuff. Optimizers, link is down below. And plus, we'll have four sports going on very soon with the NBA coming back later this month, so lots to be excited about. And last but not least, this video is sponsored by Prize Picks. I'm sure most of you know this by now, but if you don't, it's Daily Fantasy Sports Simplified, just you versus the projections. There's no Sharks, 150 max contest, or salary cap restrictions, or anything like that. Just you versus the props they offer each and every single day. And as of right now, if you're new signing over on Prize Picks, you can get a free money bonus. That's an instant deposit match up to $100, so it's free money. Why not use it to your advantage when you use code CPEN and tell them I sent you? But I think it'll be up for the plugs for the most part, so without further ado, let's dive into today's video. And as I always say, I don't think it needs to be mentioned, but don't just blindly follow this lineup and put in all of your contests. It's not a guaranteed lineup I even use. I am building on the fly right now with you guys, going over my cash game process on how I build a cash game lineup. You guys can apply it to your own favorite players. And plus, there's a lot of news that always breaks until Sunday morning, so things can obviously change. But as of right now, just going through a process here. So as I usually do in cash games, I actually want to start with the running back position, because quarterback, wide receiver 2 and 3, tight end, flex, defense are usually last piece fill-ins. But for the running backs, they're the most important part in cash games, because those are the guys that are going to be touching the ball the most. I want to make sure the guys I want in my lineup. I don't want to get stuck with some random 4K, 5K running back that I don't want to play, because in cash games, volume is very important, and I want to make sure I like the running backs I want, the matchups that I like, and the game scripts that I also like. So instead of going with quarterback first, I have a couple of mine that I like, but we're going to start with running back. And I think there's several ways you can go and build a good lineup this weekend, depending on what kind of roster construction you want to go with. I think we have two good spin-up options in Derrick Henry and Alvin Kamara. They should carry quite heavy ownership. Then you have a lot of good mid-range options this week with Najee Harris. He got 19 targets last weekend. Not sure that's going to continue, but he should still be using the passing game quite heavily since I can't get anything going on the ground. He's obviously proved that he's a good pass-catching option. You have DeAndre Swift, who should see a bigger role in the offense. Plus, he's been an excellent pass catcher so far, over 7 targets per game through 3 weeks, which is absolutely awesome usage. You have Chuba Hubbard here at $5,900. No CMC, he's going to be the starting running back. Saw around 70% of the snaps once he went down, gets a good matchup versus Dallas. And you have David Montgomery, who I assume is going to be a very, very chalky option, especially in cash games this weekend, facing that Detroit defense. The Bears were absolutely awful offensively last week versus the Browns, but this is a much softer matchup versus that Detroit run D, and they're just one of the worst defenses in all of football. And just even going down even further, there's other good options like Clyde Edwards-Helaire. But what I want to do right now is I'm just going to plug in Derrick Henry at the moment. I think you could go with Alvin Kamara. They're very close in my opinion. But with A.J. Brown and Julio Jones being out, I know people are just going to say they're going to stack the box, but teams have been doing that for a while versus the Titans for a couple years now, and Derrick Henry is still just running all over them. Plus, the Jets are allowing the third most points per game to the running back position, and they're still pretty and they're still decent-sized favorites even without those two wide receivers. So I think this is going to be a big Derrick Henry game. Should probably see close to 30 carries on the ground, probably in a few targets, which he has been involved in the passing game this season, which is even taking Derrick Henry on a even higher level than he already was. I mean, he was already an upper echelon running back, and if he's involved in the passing game, it definitely puts him even higher than he was, because he is boasting over a 12% target share in the season, which is a lot better than his usual like 5-6% target share. So Derrick Henry, I'm just going to lock in the volume here. Like 35 carries in week 2, 6 targets. Last week versus Indy, 28 carries, 3 targets. Then in week 1, they were playing from behind. It's a bad game script. I don't really see that happening here versus the New York Jets. So we're just going to plug in Derrick Henry, lock in that volume, get us 30 to 40 touches. I would take that all day. No one else in this slate is going to offer us that kind of opportunity. Then after we plug in King Henry, we're going to look for a mid-range running back. And the chalkiest option I am projecting as of right now, which is actually the chalkiest pairing, I have Derrick Henry and David Montgomery, is where most people are going to go in cash games, and I think it makes sense. I mean, David Montgomery, this Bears offense should bounce back a bit here versus Detroit. They had a brutal matchup last week versus Cleveland. That defensive line it's ferocious. You have Myles Garrett, Jadeveon Clowney, and Justin Fields was not ready for that game. But a matchup versus Detroit, and the Bears definitely should be okay. I don't really think they're going to score a ton of points here, but they are 3-point favorites at home, which does bode well for that home running back, which is David Montgomery. Should see around 15, 20 total touches here, and if he gets into the end zone, he'd be a great play for the $100. So I'm just going to eat the chalk here in cash games. Derrick Henry, David Montgomery, I expect that to be a very, very chalky pairing, but in cash games, that is totally fine. Then after that, we could either pick our quarterback or we could go with a wide receiver. There is one wide receiver I think we need to lock in for cash games this weekend. I'll tell you right now, There's a lot of good receivers on this, like Tyreek Hill, Davante Adams, Cooper Kupp, Stephon Diggs. Like, the list goes on. There's a lot. I mean, a lot of good wide receivers this weekend. But the one I'm projecting for the most ownership, so in cash games, I feel like we're just going to plug him in, is DJ Moore here at $6,600. And I realize he does get a, I guess, tougher individual matchup versus Diggs. But overall, this Dallas defense is bleeding points versus wide receivers so far this season, over 200 receiving yards allowed per game specifically versus wide receivers. And with no CMC, DJ Moore already had over a 30% target share. Everyone else gets a bump because when you're taking out a guy that gets around 30 total touches a game, obviously everyone in the offense is going to get bumped up a little bit. And DJ Moore, he's the alpha dog here, 12, 11, and 8 targets his first 3 weeks of the season. And he just feels a little bit underpriced for the potential volume and how talented he is. Sam Darnold has been able to get him the ball every single game, and he's looked very, very good. So I'm just going to plug in DJ Moore here, which should be a decently high-scoring game. This game does feature over a 50-point over-under, about a 5-point spread, so it should be pretty back and forth for the most part. And like I said, Dallas has been terrible versus wide receivers. Yes, he will see some digs, but I don't think people care because ownership-wise, he's like one of the highest-owned players in the entire slate right now. And I get it. Like, my projections have him around 20, 21 points, which at $6,600, he is popping up in my optimizer a lot. So we're going to plug him in and just get exposure to this game. And I think that's a pretty good start to cash games this weekend. Yeah, Derrick Henry, David Montgomery, and DJ Moore. So at this point, we're probably going to plug in a quarterback. We could keep going with wide receivers, but I don't want to get stuck with some scrub quarterback because, like I said, I don't mind spending down a quarterback, but I don't want to get stuck with someone I don't want. And there's a few quarterbacks I think are cash game viable this weekend. Obviously, you can always play Patrick Mahomes, but I think the two most popular options will be either Josh Allen or Jalen Hurts this weekend. Josh Allen just gets that dream matchup versus Houston. I will say the weather doesn't look great right now. I think I saw like 90% chance for light rain and a little bit of wind, which I'm not really concerned about rain. Wind, though, we'll have to make sure. But I think it was like around 10 miles per hour, which is not a big deal, so I'm not concerned about it. But we'll just check again on Sunday morning just to make sure that it doesn't get worse. But Houston, they suck defensively. Josh Allen went off last week. I mean, over 30 fantasy points. I could see that happening again. The only concern I have is that they're 17-point favorites. So if this game gets out of hand early on, they could let off the gas a little bit. But they blew out the Washington football team last week, and he still had 40 DraftKings points. So, I mean, I think he's fine. The price did hike up $1,000, but, I mean, he's got great options in Cole Beasley, Stephon Diggs, and Emmanuel Sanders. Even Dawson Knox got into the end zone, a really nice touchdown catch. This is not a team that really likes to run the football too much, and plus Josh Allen runs the ball anyway, and he's always a threat to get a rushing touchdown. So if you had the money for Josh Allen, I definitely think he's a great way to go. The problem is if we plug him in this lineup, we probably have to drop Derrick Henry because we only have $4,100 left per player. Like, we can make this work. It's just we're probably going to have to play the wide receiver one now for Tennessee and Westbrook or either Chester Rogers. I'm not really sure I want to go that route in cash games. You can. My optimizer actually does kind of like that line. Actually, it does kind of like those two guys because they're popping up a little bit. But for cash games, not exactly sure I want to go that route just yet. I mean, I don't hate it because they're very cheap in the low 3K range. But I think for this lineup, we're just going to plug in Jalen Hurts. I do want to mention I love Matthew Stafford in tournaments this weekend because I feel like a lot of people play Jalen Hurts. So Stafford should get a little bit lower owned. He's also a little bit more expensive than he was last week. But this is a good matchup versus Arizona. The game features like a 54, 55 point over-under. Pretty tight spread for the most part. Should be a very high scoring game. And Stafford has been amazing so far this season. But I just like the rushing upside that Jalen Hurts offers you. It's just a built-in floor that most quarterbacks don't offer. Like last week wasn't great, 35 rushing yards. But he had 326 passing yards. 82 the week before that and 62 in week one. So it's like a built-in 1.5 to 2 touchdown passing floor. Just in the points he gets on the ground. And whatever he does through the air is just icing on top. But this is a great matchup versus KC. They have sucked versus quarterbacks the first 3 weeks. They're dead last DBA versus the pass. And they've been terrible on the ground as well. So Jalen Hurts, I think it's a very, very good spot here for the Philadelphia Eagles offense. And Jalen Hurts seems to have been a price below $7,000. I think he's an excellent cash game quarterback this weekend with that rushing upside. And plugging him in leaves us $4,300 left per player. It's a little bit more flexibility than Josh Allen offers us. So after that, there's several ways we can start picking up the rest of this lineup. We could just throw in the cheap defense of the week. They're going to be the highest owned defense, and typically I just try to throw in the cheapest defense I can for cash games. I don't care if it correlates well or not, and I guess this week it doesn't really care. You're playing the defense against your own running back, but I don't really care. They're only $2,200. I'll just take the chalky defense here. Let's hope for a pick six for this defense or some sacks, which offensive line for the Bears obviously hasn't looked that great so far. So after that, we'll start chipping away at the wide receiver position. As far as wide receiver 2 goes this week, I do like Robert Woods a lot. I want to try to fit in guys like Tyreek Hill, Adams, and Cooper Kupp if I can at the end here for like the wide receiver 3 or flex spot. But I really like this 5K range because there's several wide receivers I think are very, very strong plays, whether it be cash games or tournaments. I love Odell in tournaments this week. Devontae Smith is a great tournament play. And if you have Jalen Hurts as your quarterback, definitely makes sense to want to correlate him with one of his pass-catching options in GPPs this weekend. Cortland Sutton, I do think, is a very interesting option there versus Baltimore, only $5,700. Cole Beasley's in a great spot versus Houston, not a big play guy, but he should get peppered with targets. Michael Pittman has nearly a 50% market share of his team's air yards so far this season. Don't really love the matchup versus Miami, but I definitely think he's in a pretty interesting spot. But the guy I'm plugged in here is Robert Woods at $5,300, and he's nearly $3,000 cheaper than his teammate Cooper Kupp at this point. Yes, I think Cooper Kupp is the better play, but you're paying a very pretty penny for it, and Devontae Adams is nearly the same price as Cooper Kupp, which I know they've both been amazing this year, but I feel like I'd rather play Devontae Adams as far as that goes. I mean, if you're playing Matthew Stafford, pair him with Cooper Kupp by all means, but in cash games, we should get over a handful of targets here. He saw 9 in week 2. And defenses are going to really start keying on Cooper Kupp at some point. Not saying that Cooper Kupp can't handle that, but at only $5,300, I think Bobby Trees is in a very good spot. This is not a good Arizona secondary. And at some point, they're going to start bracketing away Cooper Kupp, and Robert Woods is definitely going to have a blow-up game. And I want to be ahead of the curve before it happens. I do think he's actually going to have some ownership this weekend because I feel like a lot of people have the same thought process there. They shouldn't be $3,000. He's not quite $3,000, but close to it, cheaper than his teammate Cooper Kupp. So I don't mind Robert Woods here. I think he's just a little bit too cheap, in my opinion. You get exposure to what should be a very high-scoring game and a very high-scoring offense. So at this point, we have $4,800 left per player. I feel like we should probably try to find a tight end at this point. I think there's a couple good cheap options this week. Anthony Firkser is interesting without A.J. Brown or Julio Jones because the ball's going to go somewhere. Obviously, Chester Rogers, Westbrook are going to be options. But Firkser should see an uptick in usage here. He's only $3,100. Although I do think a pretty chalky option this weekend will be Evan Engram at $3,000 because similar to Firkser, there's multiple pass-catching options out in this offense. No Sterling Shepard, no Darius Slayton. So Evan Engram, who saw 6 targets in his return last week, only caught 2 of them for 21 yards. So I don't really, I'm not super confident in Evan Engram here, but the volume's going to be there. Should see over 5 targets in this game, probably playing from behind. So we'll plug in Engram at $3,000. I don't hate it. I left them off my final picks video, but made that right before those guys got rolled out. So that obviously changed some things for me, but don't think Engram is a bad play in cash games this weekend, although in tournaments, I definitely think there's some pretty good pivots off of him, like Firkser, Schultz, or a couple of other guys. We have $5,700 left per player, so we could spend up for an expensive wide receiver, then probably go with the punt option in the flex spot, or we could go like double mid-range here. So if we want like another running back in the flex spot, we'll probably have to try to get one of these 5K wide receivers, which I think is fine, because Cole Beasley is a good option. You have Odell Beckham, you have Michael Pittman. So there's like a laundry list of players here. If you guys want to see what it looks like, if you want to go with a spend-up option, we could use Cooper Kupp. The problem is, where do you have Robert Woods? And while we can play both, I feel like I only want one of those guys in cash games this weekend. In tournaments, you could play both with Matthew Stafford. I wouldn't have a problem with that. Since we already have Bobby Trees, we're just going to plug in Devontae Adams. Yes, he faces Pittsburgh, which I know has a perceived good defense, but they're like allowing the 6 or 7 most points behind the wide receivers so far this season. And we're talking about Devontae Adams here. Got nearly 40% target share in the season, just absolutely killing it so far. So we'll plug him in, which leaves us $3,500 left for our last spot, which I believe one of the Tennessee wide receivers is exactly $3,500, or he might be very close to it. So we have Deami Brown, yeah, Chester Rogers, only $3,300. Then we have Nick Westbrook here, only $3,200, who was actually productive last week. Once A.J. Brown went down, 4 targets, caught all 4 of them for 53 yards and got into the end zone. I mean, obviously, if he doesn't get into the end zone, it wasn't a fantastic day, but his price point, I mean, it's still not bad. Plus, we know he's going to have a role in this offense. If you look at what Chester Rogers did last week, he had 2 targets, caught 1 of them for a 6-yard touchdown. I mean, he's had a role in this offense the first 3 weeks. Like, you can play either of these options. I don't mind it. Just for this one, you could throw in Westbrook, and that's not really that bad of a lineup, to be honest. And even then, you could upgrade Devontae Adams to Tyreek Hill, which I'm not really sure I'd call it an upgrade, but just in terms of salary, you can move that around a little bit. If you want to go the more balanced approach instead of punting your flex, we could probably get a guy like Odell in or Michael Pittman, Cole Beasley, whatever you may prefer. If you want just a piece of that Buffalo offense, since we have absolutely none of it so far, we can plug Beasley in here, and that would leave us $6,000 for our last spot, which gives us guys like Amari Cooper, Chuba Hubbard, Kareem Hunt, which is actually a good list of players here. You have Odell. Amari Cooper seems a bit too cheap this weekend, and that would actually even out your lineup. And I don't think that looks bad at all. I mean, Jalen Hurts, Henry, Montgomery, DJ Moore, Robert Woods, Cole Beasley, Evan Engram, Amari Cooper, Lions defense. If you wanted to go the 3 running back approach, I would love to be able to fit in DeAndre Swift, although the problem is I'm not sure it's going to work that well. If we go that route, that's leaving us right behind some guys I want. Like, if Pittman was there, Cole Beasley, I'd feel great about that. But I don't want to play 2 Panthers wide receivers in cash games this weekend, so we're probably not going to be able to go the DeAndre Swift route, just if you happen to have this similar build that I have. But a cheap running back I do like, I believe it's only $5,400, is Clyde Edwards-Helaire. He's a 7-point favorite at home. He was great last week, rebounded after a very poor week 2 where he fumbled the game away, only 3.6 fantasy points, but had 21 points last weekend, got the 100-yard bonus on DraftKings, 2 targets, caught a touchdown, $5,400. I don't mind that whatsoever, which leaves just $6,000 left for the last spot. You could play Odell. You could play Amari Cooper. And that does not look like a bad lineup whatsoever. So Jalen Hurts, Henry, Montgomery, Moore, Woods, Cooper, Ingram, Allaire, and Lions defense. But as you guys can see, there are several ways to go, making some pretty strong lineups this weekend. And if you did find this video helpful in any way possible, make sure you leave a like, subscribe to the channel if you haven't yet already. If you want to take that one step further, you can official member over on Patreon. Link is down below in the description for that. We'll have 4 sports going on soon, so it's going to be a busy time, but lots of extra content that I think you guys will enjoy. So if you want to check it out, we got a couple hundred people over there. Be more than happy to have you. And don't forget, this video was sponsored by Prize Picks. It's just you versus the projections. And as of right now, if you're new signing over there, you can get a free money bonus after $100. When you use code CPEN and tell them I sent you. But I think it'll be it. I will stop rambling. I'll see you guys in the core plays video that I post later tonight at 9.